That's not going to work. God will not have that. It's going to take your whole life. You have to give your whole life over to God. It's not that easy. You can't just believe and have a head knowledge that Christ died on the cross and say, well, I know that happened, but I'll recognize that on Sunday. I'll just recognize that on Sunday. But you know what? I got to get mine now. I got to get my best life now. That's not how it works. God wants your whole life.
Amen.
He wants all of you. He wants you to give up your idolatry. He wants you to give up your sex outside of marriage. He wants you to give up your drug use. He wants you to give up your alcoholism. He wants it all gone. You cannot have those things and inherit the kingdom of God.
Amen.
The Bible says, let all those who name Christ Jesus depart from iniquity. Depart from sin.
Good verse.
He demands it. It's a command of God. There's a lot of grace teaching around that says, we're all sinners. We can't stop doing what we do. This is just, we're human. Humans just do this. It's just what we do. We can't stop. We have to drink. We have to party. We have to. We just can't stop. It's just a fantasy to think that we can stop sinning. But God's truth is true and every man a liar, the Bible says.
Amen.
God is true and every man a liar. Men are the ones that say you can't stop living. You can't be holy. Men are saying that. Men are saying you can't stop sinning. God says you can do it. He commands it. Would he command something you can't do?
Nope.
Would God Almighty command something you aren't able to do? And he wants you to do it for your own good. For your own good. Think about it, what sin does to you. It kills you. It kills you. That's the devil's job, is to kill you. That's why God wants you to give up your sin. Because if you're in sin, you're living for the devil. That's what he uses to kill you. And the majority of this world, the sad thing is, the majority of this world is following Satan. They believe the lie. They believe the lie that they can't live holy.
Very true.
That they can't stop sinning. They believed it. Because they've been told. They turn on their TVs and see these false prophets of Satan telling them that they're going to heaven no matter how they live. They're buying the lie. It's a big lie. That's what's being taught. Not only on television, but in a lot of churches. A lot of churches. A lot of churches don't want to tell you the truth because they're scared to lose their congregation. Because half the congregation is in sin. What happens when the congregation leaves? Money leaves.
No more church.
But they shouldn't be worried about that because God supplies our need. You need to be telling the truth. If you're telling the truth and you're following God, he will supply your needs.
Amen.
Your church won't fold. Your church won't fold. The only thing that's going to happen is you're going to go to hell for preaching a false message, a false grace.
Amen.
The grace is this. This is grace. Jesus Christ came to this earth and suffered a brutal death for our sins, for my sin and your sin. That's God's reprieve for us. That's God's saving grace for us, that he would come and he would die on a cross. He would be beaten and he would be mocked and spit on for us.
Follow
for
me, Jesus.
For you. That's grace. Now we got a chance to turn to him. God gave us a chance to believe in him and to give up our evil lives. Give it all up, everything. It's an easy thing to do when you put it all together. It's an easy thing to do. Just give it up. Give it up. Give up your life. Give up the pipe dream. That's what God commands. And that's the grace of God, that He gives us the chance. He took the punishment. He took my punishment. He took your punishment. All you got to do is turn it over to Him now. Follow Him. That's grace. That's grace. Grace is not go out and do whatever you want to do and you can go to heaven just because you got a head knowledge of God. That's not grace. That's a lie.
Amen.
That's a lie. Just sick of hearing that. You know, that's all we hear being taught. I mean, there's a handful of people that I know that actually know the truth, that actually read their Bible and see what it says. This is how you can understand God's word. This is how you do it. This is how you understand God's word. You come to Him with a broken heart over your sin. You realize that you need a Savior. You come to Him with a broken heart. You come with Him and you tell and you beg for mercy and you say, I can't do it on my own, Lord, but I'm ready to give it all up for you. I'm ready to follow you. I'm ready to follow what your word says. And the Holy Spirit will come in, live inside of you. His Spirit will come in at that moment. And you can open up the Bible and now you can understand it. Now you can read His word and see what it says. Because if you're living in sin and you go reading the word, you may get a few things, but you're going to be blind to most of it. That's the way the Spirit of God works.
Blind.
He's not going to show you things if you're in your sin. You come clean. You give it all up. You just, I'm God, I'm going to follow you. Show me how. Open the pages. There it is. It's like blinders fall off. It's like blinders fall off. You can now see it. You can understand it. You start to see things in a different light. You can see what's going on in front of you. You can see the evil in this world. You can see it right now. Half of you are blind. More than half of you are blind. I know it. I was there. I was there. I walked blind for years and years listening to this false teaching from the church. You know what? I came to the point of suicide, finally. After following false teaching for 20 some odd years, I was ready to take my own life. Satan almost had me. He had me right where he wanted to. After all the lies that I had been listening to, the way I've been living my life, I was ready to end it. And I would have ended up straight in hell.
Amen.
I would have took my last breath and woke up in hell.
Yep.
That's how he works. That's how he tries to get you. That's Satan's big lie. Everything is just fine. Go ahead, do what you want to do. Go to church on Sunday, get right with God. That's a lie. That's a lie. I'm living proof. I know God's real because now I know the difference. The real miracles that God can do, I know what they are because I'm one of them.
Amen.
I'm one of them. I gave up. I was on narcotics for 2 years. 2 years heavy narcotics. I didn't need no 12-step program. I had a one-step program. Jesus Christ. One step.
Yeah.
Over.
Done.
Over and done, man. Amen. That's the miracles of God. That's something He can do.
Praise the Lord.
All you have to do is come to Him. I'm all yours, God. I'm all yours now. I don't want this world. I don't want the things of this world. I don't want the lust of this world. The happiness of this world is it's a vapor. Here and gone.
Yeah.
Rust. The grass withers. The flower fades. It's all vanity. It's what the Bible says.
Amen.
The life you live here on earth is vanity. It's a vapor. It's gone. Here and gone.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ is eternal. Life in Jesus Christ, everlasting life, is eternal.
Mm.
brothers out here. They look destitute. People look at them. They don't give them the time of day. You know what? They're probably in a better place than most of you.
Uh-huh.
They're in a better place than most of you because they don't have to worry about the cares of this life.
Yeah.
They're just fine. You know, living their days out. Praise God. I hope they find Jesus. I hope they know who they are.
Yeah.
I hope they find him and they know who he is. But they're not distracted by money. They're not distracted by alcohol. Well, some of them are, but you know, that's between them and the Lord. But they're not distracted by the lusts of this world when it comes to money and fame and all that garbage and being known. They're just living their life out. And hopefully, by God's grace, they give their lives to the Lord. That's all they got to do. It's easier for them. It's easier for them.
Gain the whole world, lose your soul.
I would rather be in prison and go to heaven. I pray to God that he would put me in prison to keep me away from the sins of this world.
Mm.
By God's grace, I'm free. You know, because I told him, this is something I prayed to him. I said, put me away, Lord. Keep me away from the sins of this world that will take me to hell for eternity.
Been there.
I'm free so far. But I don't plan on going back to my sin.
Yeah.
Ever. That's not to say I might not stumble. I might not stumble, but hey, I can get back up. I pick up my cross again. You drop your cross, you pick it right back up. So far I've been good. Ever since I decided not to be in sin, I may have had some thoughts, but I didn't act on those thoughts. They were just thoughts.
Cast them down.
They come from Satan. Satan can put thoughts in your head. You can take them captive and cast them back out. You give Satan God's word. When he puts thoughts in your mind, you give him back God's word, and you're free. It's when you act on those thoughts that it becomes sin. When it becomes physical activity. You get the thought and you say, that sounds good. Let me do that. That's sin, when you actually go and do it. Not just because you had thought. That thought is temptation. That thought is Satan coming into your mind, telling you got to do these things. These things will be good for you. That's what Satan did from the beginning with Adam and Eve. He put thoughts in their mind. You surely won't die. That's what he said. He tempted them.
Yeah.
But sin does lead to death. It does lead to death because I'm proof of it. I was right there at death's door. If I would have kept going like I was, there's no way I'd be walking here right now.
Amen. Me too.
No way. And a preacher got me out of it. I heard a preacher, street preacher, showed me scriptures. Had to take me there because I was blind to see it. Had to take me there and say, look. He who sins is of the devil. Really? How did I miss that?
Yeah.
Well, anyway, God's true. Let every man be a liar. Read the scriptures for yourself. Take time to open the Bible. Read the scriptures for yourself. Remember, come to him. Come to him humble. God, I want to know you. I want to know you, God. I'm going to give up all the things I know I shouldn't be doing. Show me the truth. Show me the truth. Let me read the truth. And he'll open your eyes. He'll make it so you can read it. Read the truth. Know the truth. Accept the truth. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life.
No one comes to the Father.
I am the way, the truth, and the life. And nobody comes to the Father except through me.
Amen.